In this laboratory activity, you will test the effectiveness of disinfectants and antiseptics. It is smart to spend a few minutes ahead of time thinking about which you would like to test. As a reminder, disinfectants are chemicals used to clean inanimate objects, while antiseptics are used on the skin. For each chemical you test, you will need two areas on the surface of a plate. You can test up to four chemicals on a single plate. You may use any disinfectant or antiseptic of your choice. You can just wash your hands with water and soap instead of an antiseptic. Feel free to be creative. Label a TSA plate. With a marker, draw lines to divide the plate into roughly equal segments. You will need two for each chemical. In this example, I will just use two chemicals, so I divide my plate into four equal parts. Label each part and add before and after so you know which is which. For example, I will clean my kitchen counter with disinfectant, so I will have a counter before and a counter after area on my plate. I will also use hand sanitizer on my hands after rubbing my phone, so I will have a phone before and a phone after area. Start by washing your hands really well. If you are testing how effective a disinfectant is in cleaning a surface, rub a finger vigorously over the surface. Open the plate and press your finger onto the surface of the medium in the before area. Wash your hands again. Then clean the surface with a disinfectant of your choice. In my case, I sprayed Lysol disinfectant on the counter and wiped it down with a paper towel. Then you rub your finger over the clean surface and press it onto the surface of the medium in the after area. For an antiseptic, again, start by washing your hands well. Rub the surface of your choice, in my case, my phone. Press your finger in the before area, then clean your finger with the antiseptic of your choice. I used hand sanitizer. Now press your finger in the after area. Incubate your plate in the warmest part of your home. I saw results the next day, but you may have to wait another day depending on the temperature of your home. To describe your results, compare the before and after areas for each disinfectant and antiseptic you used. How many colonies are there before and after? Did your treatment reduce the numbers? Did your treatment reduce the number of different kinds of colonies? Sometimes you may actually see an increase in the number of colonies. That may be explained by the growth of that particular bacterium, call it A, kept in check by another kind, say B. And B, but not A, is killed by the treatment, allowing A to grow when B does not. What is your opinion of the disinfectants and/or antiseptics that you used?